Fine students, this is exercise 16B we will start today. And before starting 16B, we will first understand the definition of polygon. Okay, the first point it says a simple closed plane figure formed by line segment is called a polygon. It is a simple closed figure which is formed by line segment. Suppose I draw like this. Okay, so these are line segments. This is AB, BC, DE. So AB, BC, CD, DE, and EA are the line segments. Okay, so thus it is forming a what? Polygon. Firstly, first point is that it is formed by simple closed figure. Means the figure should be closed, and second, it should be attached by the line segment, formed by the line segment. Okay. Second point is that the line segment is called the side. This line segment means these are the sides of this polygon. AB is the side, BC is the side, CD is the side, DE is the side, and EA is the side of the polygon. Each point, each end point of the side is called vertex. So put this from here, A it is starting and B it will end. So this end point is known as the vertex. For BC, C is the this is known as the vertex. For CD, this is each end point, means this point and this point both are known as the vertex here. These two are the important formulas which we are going to use in this exercise. First, it is area of equilateral triangle. Okay, area of equilateral formula is root 3 by 4 into side square. Suppose let us take the side as A. So the formula will be root 3 by 4 into A square. This formula we are going to use in this chapter. So note down in your copy. Next is area of the hexagon. Hexagon means having six sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So what is the formula for hexagon? As it is having six sides, it will be multiplied by 6 into root 3 by 4 into A square. Okay. Means A square means side square. So area of hexagon is how much? 6 into 6. Why? Because this is hexagon. So we have multiplied here with 6 into root 3 by 4 into side square. Now you will say, madam, what is root 3 here? So whenever you will solve question related to this, you will get the value of root 3. So value of root 3 is 1.732. So whenever you use this formula, in place of root 3, you can write the value as 1.732. Now we are starting with exercise 16B. First question here. Find the area of the polygon. This is a polygon. Okay. So we have to find out the area of the polygon. So area of the polygons means here we are having two polygons. First one is this and second one is this. Okay. So first, in the first polygon, if you see, this is triangle. It is forming a triangle. And in the second polygon, if you see, this is a trapezium here. So one, how can I write down solution? That is area of triangle. Sorry, area of polygon. Area of polygon is equal to area of triangle plus area of trapezium. Okay. If I want to find out the area of the whole polygon, area of triangle plus the area of the trapezium. So first find out area of triangle. In area of triangle A E D. So okay, the formula for area of triangle is half into base into height. So half, what is the base here? Okay, base here half, it is given to you as 6 cm. Base is given to you as 6 cm. Okay, so half into base into height. So base is 6 cm and height is how much? 8. Okay, so 2 ones are 24. Okay, this is centimeter square, 24 centimeter square. Similarly, we will take out the area of the trapezium, that is equal to area of the trapezium EDBC. So area of trapezium formula is half into sum of parallel side, that is B1 plus B2 into height. Okay, so from here you will get half into B1 is 12 centimeter, B2 is 6. Parallel side mean this and this, 12 and 6 centimeter. Now we have to find out the height. For height, this is the total height from A to C. If I want the height of the trapezium means BC. So how will AC minus BC, you will AC minus AD, if you minus from 13 centimeter, if you minus 8 centimeter, you will get value of BC. That means AC minus AD, that is how much? 13 minus 8. 13 minus 8 centimeter. Okay. From here you will get 1 by 2. This is 18 and this is 13 minus 8 is 5. So 2 ones are 2 nines are. So the area will be 9 into 5, that is 5 nines are 45 centimeter square. Okay. Now what we have to find out, area of the polygonal, that is equal to area of the triangle plus area of the trapezium. So area of the triangle is 24 centimeter square plus area of the trapezium is how much? 45 centimeter square. So what you will get? 5 plus 4 is 9. 2 plus 4 is 6. So 69 centimeter square. So area of this polynomial is how much? 69 centimeter square. So for finding area of polynomial is equal to area of hexagon plus area of rectangle. So first we will find out area of hexagon. Area of hexagon formula is hexa means 6. So 6 into root 3 by 4 into side square plus area of rectangle is length into breadth here. So area of hexagon is 6 into root 3 by 4 into sides. If you can see, that is 8. All the sides are 8 centimeter. So 8 into 8 plus length into breadth. Area of rectangle, length is 12 and breadth is 4. So 12. Okay, so from here you can write down 2 2's are, 2 3's are. And the value of root 3 I told you, that is root 3 is equal to 1.732. So write down the value 1.732 by 2. Okay, 8 are 64 plus 8 is 64 plus 12 is 48. Okay, now cancel this. If you can cancel this, you can cancel. 2 1's are, 2 3's are, 2 2's are. On solving this, you will get 166.272 plus 48. On adding this 2, you will get 214.272. On solving this 2, by multiplying this and this, you will get this much and this 48 is there. On adding this, you will get 214.272. So this is the total area of the polygon. That is area of hexagon plus area of the rectangle. This question number 1, third portion. Third portion means you have to find out the area of this polygon. So as it was plain, I have drawn here one line and one line. One first, this is a rectangle. This also is. This is trapezium and third it is forming a rectangle. First rectangle, second rectangle and third is the trapezium. Okay. So what was given? AB was given to you as total 25. EI was given to you as 11 meter. And this I am naming it with DC. Okay. And DC is given to you as 10 meter. You have to find the value of FG. Because we have made this one trapezium. So from here I have written all the values, like AB is equal to 25 meter, measurement it is written, DC is 10 meter, and all this I have written. Okay, we have to find FG. So how we will find FG? Okay, so FG is how much? EI plus CD. This is the total measurement 25. So 25 minus 11 and plus 10. So you will get how much? FG, and that will be equal to how much? 4 meter. Similarly, GH you have to find out. So GH is this. Okay, GH you have to find out. If this is total BC is 19.5 and you are given HD is 5.5, so 19.5 minus 5.5 you will get how much? 14. So GH here you will get as 14 meter. Now you know we are having three. You have to find three areas. So first of this rectangle, then this rectangle, then the third one is the trapezium. So as you know, the area of polygon is equal to area of rectangle AFIE plus area of rectangle GBCD plus area of trapezium FGHI. Okay. So you know formula for area of rectangle, that is length into breadth. Here also length into breadth. Plus trapezium is half into B1 plus B2 sum of parallel side into the height here. Okay. So area of, first we will see this rectangle AFIE. So what is the length and what is the breadth here? Length is 11 and breadth is 6. So 11 into 6, that is 66 meters square plus this rectangle. The length is 19.5 into 10. That is 19.5 into 10. That is 195 meter square. Now for the third is the trapezium. That is half into B1 plus B2. Half into B1 plus B2 means this is 14 and this is 6. So 14 plus 6 into H is how much? 4. So from here, half into, this is 20 into 4. 2 ones are, 2 twos are. So this you will get 66 meter square plus 195 meter square plus 40 meter square. So total how you will find? 66, 195 and 40. So from 6 plus 5 is 11, 10, 10. This is the total here, 66, 195 and 40. 6 plus 5 is 11, 11 carry 1. 10 plus 6 is 16, 10 plus 6 is 16 and plus 4 is 20. 0 carry 2, that is 301. So total area here you will get 301 meter square. So in this way you have to find the area of the polygon. This chapter is, this exercise is very easy, just you need to see the correct measurement to find out the area of the polygon. See, this is question number 5th of this exercise. It is given, a school crossing sign have dimension as shown in the figure. Firstly you have to find the area of the signboard. Okay, now if the four such signboards are cut from a rectangular metal sheet, means if such four signboard are cut from a rectangular sheet, then the length is given to you as 350 and breadth is given to you as 220. You have to find out what will be the area of the metal left over. So first we will find the area of this signboard. So for area of the signboard, first let me name this as A, B, C, D and E. This is the first one and this is the second one. Okay. So first we will find out the area of this signboard. Area of signboard is equal to area of triangle plus area of rectangle. Okay. So area of triangle formula, you know, that is half into base into height, and rectangle is, you know, length into breadth. So half into base is area of triangle same, and this is 76, so this will also be 76. Okay, now what is given? Total from E to B it is given 76 cm and B to A it is given 38. So what will be the remaining EC? 76 minus 38, so this will also be 38. Okay, this is also 38 cm. So here base is how much? 76, and this is 38 plus length you are given with 76 and breadth is given to you as 38. Now calculate, you will get 2 ones are and 2 nines are. So 76 multiplied by 19 you will get 1444. Okay, again 76 multiplied by 38 you will get 2888. Adding this two both you will get 4332. Okay, so this is the area of this signboard. Question it is saying, if such four signboards are cut from a rectangular metal is there, from there such four metal sheets are cut. So what will be the leftover metal? It is saying, so here length is given and breadth is given. So area of the sheet I can find out. So area of the sheet is length into breadth, that is 350 into 320, you got this much. Okay, now area of four signboard, because you have to cut four signboard from that metal sheet. So area of four signboard is 4 multiplied this area of this signboard, that is 4 into this much. Okay, so you got the area of the 4 signboard. Now you have to find out the leftover metal. Okay, so leftover metal means this sheet minus this minus this area of the 4 signboard, because this is a sheet and from here you have to take out 4 signboard. So after taking out 4 signboard, how much metal is left? So what you will do, this minus this, area of sheet minus area of signboard, you will get the area of the metal sheet here. Okay, similarly with this we can finish this exercise here. Two questions are there for MCQ, solve that, and chapter assignment also you have to solve. Whatever exercise is given in the back you have to solve that, because from Monday your school is going to start and I will start with a new chapter. So whatever the portion is remaining in this, you have Sunday, you try to solve this MCQs and chapter assignment, and if possible worksheets we will solve in school, or if you can solve within Sunday you can solve this. So be ready that today, that one from Monday your school is getting started, and we be well prepared, maintain discipline there, be like maintain distance with your friends also, so that we can fight with this coronavirus again. So all of you welcome back to the school on Monday and finish this exercise and come. So thank you for today. Have a nice day.